Hey, we're here in the meteoritics lab with Jim Holstein.
Hi, I'm the collection manager of physical geology and meteorites. And Emily, are you ready to go on a most excellent adventure today?
Why, absolutely.
You know what we're going to talk about today?
No, I don't.
We're talking about deadly minerals, and we call them death rocks.
So today we're going to learn about some deadly rocks.
And in front of us, we have a few examples of dangerous minerals. And these aren't necessarily deadly, but it depends on your exposure and how you work with these materials.
Okay, Jim. First, I think we need to do a review of the basics.
Pop quiz, Emily.
Yeah.
What's this?
An atom.
And in the center of the atom, we call it the nucleus. And nucleus is made out of what?
Protons and neutrons.
And around the nucleus?
Electrons.
And these atoms are the building blocks of all matter. And this is expressed in the periodic table, of which we have four examples. Magnesium, iron, silicon, and...
oxygen.
Yeah. And these elements come together to form compounds. And these compounds sometimes form minerals. In the case of these four elements, they form the mineral olivine. And this lovely diagram is a rock. And rocks are aggregates of different minerals. So you can have olivine inside of different types of rocks. Olivine is not a death rock, by the way. It's not even dangerous. But we use this as an example to show what rocks, minerals, elements, and atoms are made out of. So the first deadly mineral is a mineral called stibnite. And this is made out of an element called antimony. And people used to take this mineral because it's this beautiful metallic material and make eating utensils out of it. So not only were they breathing the dust in, when they were working with this material, they were actually putting the material into their mouth. And this can potentially cause cancer. So a lot of people got poisoned from this mineral. Next up, we have galena.
So Jim, what makes galena harmful?
Well, it's an ore of lead. And you've heard of people getting lead poisoning. So from lead paint and so forth. And if it gets into your body or bloodstream, it can build up over time and cause organ failure, seizures, coma, and death if exposed to enough of it. This next one, Emily, we need to wear gloves.
Okay.
So did the gloves snap?
You're way ahead of me.
There you
yes.
go. All right, time it.
Okay.
Time it.
My hand's sweaty. Okay.
Ready? Perfect. So this one looks like pyrite.
Mm-hmm.
But it's called arsenopyrite. And it's called that because it contains arsenic. And arsenic can cause organ failure, can cause coma, seizures, hair loss, and death potentially. So this was a very popular poison that people used to use. It's colorless, it's odorless, and it's very deadly. This next mineral is called asbestos. It's one of the most deadly minerals known to man. It has these really beautiful, thin, fibrous crystals inside of it. And these fibers are so small that they get you can breathe them in and they get trapped in your lungs and they can cause cancer. They cause lung cancer, they cause another type of cancer called mesothelioma. And a lot of people were killed by this mineral. And it's a sort of a catch-all term for six minerals. These were really popular to use in manufacturing as well as building because they're flame retardant. There are no safe exposure limits for asbestos. You can be exposed to a fair amount of asbestos over a couple of days and develop cancer down the road, 10, 20 years down the line. So this is a mineral called monazite, and it contains an element called thorium. And thorium is unstable, which means that it breaks down from one element to another over time. So rocks that contain monazite can be used for radiometric dating. So scientifically, these types of rocks are very important. But anyone who has who's an amateur collector or a professional collector who has radioactive minerals in their collection should take precautions. And these should be stored in a room that people don't occupy very often. People shouldn't smoke, eat, or drink around them.
Can I ask why a private citizen or individual would want to have a piece of radioactive material in their
because
house?
Because it's cool as all get out.
Can you just bust it out at a party?
Yeah, bust out at a party and say, look at my radioactive rock.
And be like, Harry,
check it out.
Put out the rock, put the rock away. We don't need to see that right
now. Put your hot rocks back in the room. Of the three radioactive particles that this mineral is emitting, gamma radiation is the most dangerous. And that's something you have to be very careful around because it can destroy tissue. It goes through just about anything other than lead shielding. And it can destroy tissue and organs and cause cancer. So I brought one up that isn't terribly radioactive, but it is emitting particles. And what this is capturing are events, basically. It's probably capturing gamma radiation at this point, but not alpha or beta particles.
So this one doesn't seem to be all too powerful.
Yeah, I brought one up that wasn't as radioactive as other specimens
well,
in our collection.
You. Well,
you're welcome. But how about we go downstairs and look at the other ones?
Yeah!
So Emily, now we're down in the collection. We have over 16,000 mineral specimens from all over the world.
Yeah.
And some of them are, you know, can be kind of dangerous.
Yeah.
So we looked at the radioactive mineral upstairs, and I was saying there's more radioactive minerals down here. This is our cabin of radioactive minerals.
Is that why it says caution radiation
area? That's why it says caution radiation area.
Also the Geiger counter.
And the Geiger counter saying it is too. I calculated that if you're standing in front of this cabinet for about an hour, it's the equivalent of taking a round trip plane flight from New York to LA. And a 20 minute exposure in front of this cabinet is the equivalent of getting a chest x-ray.
Oh.
Yeah. So there's a fair amount of radiation coming out of this, but you know, it's one of those things that once you know the dangers and the risk, you mitigate those risks. You limit your exposure.
If you're going to pick a cabinet to stand in front of, maybe don't pick this one.
Pick another cabinet.
Yeah.
This mineral is called cinnabar. Doesn't it sound yummy?
It does.
Mm. And the mineral itself is actually red, and people would carve these minerals for ornamentation, for jewelry, and so forth. But cinnabar has mercury in it. And mercury can be a pretty deadly mineral.
Yeah.
It's something that the body doesn't need. It's something that gets into your bloodstream. It can cause organ damage. It can cause seizures, coma, and death. You're seeing there's a common theme going on
here?
Yeah,
lots
seizures, comas, and death. Ooh, that's gonna be a good song. Let's do a rap called Seizures, Comas, and Death.
Like deadly rock, seizures, coma, and death. Deadly rocks. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was great.
That was horrible.
This is the final death rock. Is this the deadliest rock we're looking at today?
I would say it's up there. This is called Hutchinsonite, and this is a combination of three potentially deadly elements. Thallium, lead, and arsenic. It is a brutal cocktail. Individually, these elements can kill you, but altogether, they can kill you three times. And, you know, some of these can cause hair loss, cancer, and what else do you think?
Coma,
seizures,
organ failure, seizures, and death. Was that how it went?
Coma, seizures, and death.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Coma, seizures, and death.
Okay.
Death rock.
Rocking on.
So, Jim, I have to ask, you have all of these beautiful specimens in front of us. It's obvious that these wouldn't make it on display. They're too dangerous.
Right.
You wouldn't want to have people interacting with them. But what is the value of having them in a museum collection?
So, yeah, this is part of our scientific reference collection. So if you have a researcher that's studying a particular mineral, we want to make sure we have full coverage of those minerals in our collection. And so as a repository of minerals that are representative of localities around the world, it is our obligation to have these in our collection. You know, science is uncovering new things. You learn more things about it. Asbestos at one time, up until the middle of last century, was thought to be safe till people started getting sick and started dying from these things. And scientific research had another look, and medical research had another look at it to discover these people were in fact becoming sick and ill from these rocks.
Wow. So I'm glad that we know that about these things, that I didn't have to contribute to that body of knowledge in a positive or negative way, you know, by dying. And it's great that we have them in a collection.
Absolutely.
So and you should learn more about them.
Always know your rocks. And Emily?
Yeah.
Party on, Emily.
Party on, Jim.
Party on soon.
It still has brains on it.